What's up, challengers? Welcome to the gym. My name is Gym Leader Geo, and this is GBA Season 5, Week 6 for the Giantes. We are going up against the Atlanta Hawluchas and their coach, Fizwalt Star Dustington Jr. But he, you know, Fizwalt is his dad's name, so he goes by Fizzy or Yo Fizz or Fizzy Stardust, aka this and that. He's got a good team. We are battling very late in the week. It is actually Sunday today, and we had a crazy busy week. He told me he worked multiple super long days. I have been working every day or doing stuff after. You guys don't care about this. I'm gonna hit battle start. We're bringing the battle box. If you guys are interested in the Pokemon I brought for this week, go check out the locker room. I have on the right here the Pokemon I predict he's bringing, and wow, he's bringing a lot of mon I did not expect him to. I am glad he's not bringing the Charizard Y. I am. That'll make things better for me. He's bringing the Chestnut, though. That's really surprising. So, he's not bringing the Zard Y. He's not bringing the Garchomp, either. Or the Heliolisk. Things are okay. He does have the Starmie. He does have the Stoutland. He does not have the Weezing. So, I'm okay. I'm okay with this. I'm positive he's got some tricks up his sleeve. I believe he brought the Chestnut because he wants to hazard stack. Were I a gambling man, that would be my assumption. Which does stink just a smidgen-y bit. What I could do, we see he has no ground type, because I think he wasn't predicting me to bring the Manectric. So I could lead with Manectric. And I could do a couple of things with that. I'm going to lead with Manectric, because if he opts to lead with Chestnut, I can Volt Switch on it if I need be, or I can just overheat right away. So I'm going to do that, I think. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I wanted to lead Hippowdon, opening up against one of his Stealth Rockers, but I really wasn't expecting him to bring a Spiker. So he's definitely going to try hazard stacking. Luckily, I do have the Latias this time, so I can defog a little bit. He's going to lead with El Guapo. He is going to lead going straight away for the spikes. I'm going to lead with Omar. There's really no reason for him to stay in here. I'm sure he's sufficiently terrified that I'm going to go straight away for the overheat. He doesn't have Zard, so anyone can be switcherooed. I don't really want to switcheroo right now, because I want to be able to outspeed the Starmie. It's kind of risky to overpredict turn one, but if he goes into Tyranitar, I am definitely pursuit bait following that. Let's think here. If I can take a pursuit, Manectric versus Tyranitar. I can, but it'll do a hell of a lot of damage. Who do I Yeah, you know what? I'm going to Volt Switch here. If he does stay in and goes straight away for... He's going to stay in. I should have just gone for the overheat. Wow. How about that? Okay. So he's going to go straight away for spikes. Probably. The red one resists a lot of what he could potentially have for me. But, again, baits in T-Tar. So I could instead just go straight away for Cuddles or Entei. I'm annoyed that I didn't just click Overheat. I shouldn't have. It's probably going to go for Spikes. Latias can freely come in on those Spikes and defog. His best answer to, and I'm going to bring in decisions right now. See what he goes for here. I'm assuming it's spikes. It is spikes. So he wants to get those hazards up right away. Now, his best switch right now is probably into T-Tar. I wouldn't mind burning it and scaring out this guy with a Sacred Fire. I could go for the Iron Head to hit the T-Tar super effective. And would it do the job? Pretty sure it would. He could be fully defensive, but I will learn that immediately, and Iron Head still might be a two-hit KO. Who else does he have that would want to switch in on this? Let's go Iron Head here. We're gonna go Iron Head. I'm predicting the T-Tar to come in because that's his primary answer to decisions. If he wants to stay in here and get spikes up, he's kind of just using a lot of... He might go for Spiky Shield. He's going to go for Spiky Shield. He's going to go for Spiky Shield to see what I lock myself into. Shoot. Iron Head won't do much to him because it is resisted. That's too bad. He could probably survive a Sacred Fire anyway, so... He might just... Man. If he's just playing ballsy right out the gate just to get up hazards, then that's kind of bad. He is going to withdraw. Okay. Okay. Thank goodness for that. Uncle Alan, who is his Starmie, who also resists the Iron Head. Does a decent amount. He could safely predict the switch here. What could he go for? Uncle Alan has got a lot. He could predict the Latias here and go straight away for the Ice Beam. He could go straight for the Psy Shock. Analytic, that's going to do a lot. He could go for the Scald. Because it'll hit me super effective, and Zoolander will take that just fine. Unfortunately, being locked into Iron Head is not going to do much to him. I can't take... Alright, let's see Vaporeon. A Psy Shock will do a decent amount because of Analytic, but I still think I want to do that switch anyway. He might double back into Chestnut here. Let's go Zoolander anyway. Mad at myself for not going for that overheat first turn. Yeah, he's gonna go for the Surf. I'll water absorb that. Okay, so Surf. We see Surf on the Starmie. Just taking notes for myself here. Let's go Wish. Just in case he opts to go for a Psy Shock here. Now he's gonna recover, kind of scout me out. So we know Surf and Recover. Fairly fair assumption that he has Rapid Spin. I'm predicting his last move is Ice Beam. Meaning he can't really touch me. He could have Psy Shock. He could. I doubt it. At this point, I really doubt he has it. A couple things I could do here. Set up the rain and start going for Scalds. He's just trying to keep his Starmie healthy. He's going to switch out here. I'm going to go for the Scald. Just try and get a burn on something. He does have Psy Shock. Okay, last move Psy Shock, so he can't touch Latias. I've seen his full move set. Maybe I'll get a burn. I do get a burn. That's nice. And I'll take that full recovery from the wish now. So he's at 50%. I could pop off another wish here. Surf and Psyshock. I mean, it's possible he doesn't have Rapid Spin. It's possible. He might have Ice Beam and not have any way of hazard clearing. And I'd just be counting on Latias to do it for him if I ever set up rocks on his side. He could definitely be doing that. Do I think he has Rapid Spin? He has Recover, so I feel like he wants to keep it healthy. So I think he does have Rapid Spin there. I'm going to. He could recover here as I go for the wish. Let's go for a wish anyway, just because I don't want him to be Psyshocking me left and right. He's gonna withdraw. We'll see into whom. El Guapo. Okay, El Guapo. Chestnut. Now, he could have Taunt. As far as dark moves are concerned, he could have Payback. He could have Bite if I switch into Latias. And they could do a fairly decent amount, but I think I might do that switch anyway, and here's why. I'm pretty sure I can hurt that Tyranitar a lot. Tyranitar, even if it's a support set, because I'm pretty sure it'll be max defense invested. Probably Impish, and my Latias might be able to kill it. After an Ice Beam and a Draco? No, I don't think so. Absolutely not. Yeah, and I'll probably drop to Pursuit. I won't die to it. I won't die to it. Well, I could double. I'm really pushing it here. Let's go decisions. And we'll see. He may switch here himself. Or he may attack. Just trying to get some heat off on what's in front of him. He's gonna Leech Seed. Okay, so we've seen Leech Seed and Spikes. Leech Seed and Spikes. So, what's the play to make here? Starmie is already burned unless it's not analytic and natural curing. And probably. I think I want to just Sacred Fire here. Because I really would like to get the burn on that Tyranitar if it comes in. I'm gonna click Sacred Fire. He might overpredict and stay in thinking I'm not gonna go for it again, or he might go for Spiky Shield this time if he has it. Given what I've seen him do, Leech Seed Spikes, it would make sense. Maybe as. Because he knows I don't have a taunter, so he doesn't even need an attacking move. He could be Spikes, Leech Seed. But he's gonna want. Is he gonna want Synthesis? Spiky Shield? Maybe Toxic? There's a lot of things he could do here. Knowing his full set would be really useful for me. I'd like him to reveal a few other things, because then I can start knowing better how to treat him. At this point, I'm pretty sure he doesn't have coverage for Latias. But again, with Tyranitar in the back, I think if he had Spiky Shield, he would have gone for it already. So he's going to switch this time, probably into Tyranitar this time. Let's get a burn. Nah, the T-Tar. Alright, let's see what kind of set this man is. That's going to hit him for a little less than half and not get the burn. A little less than half with the Sacred Fire. Sacred Fire, wow, that means no defense investment. Probably no HP investment either. So I'm predicting Scarfed then. Tyranitar. Could be banded. Probably scarfed. Could be banded, though. A pursuit will hit me for about 50% if he goes for it. Obviously, a Stone Edge will straight up kill me. Like, straight up. EQ will also kill me. If he's scarfed... Okay. Well, the question is, what's he gonna do? If I switch out, I survive a pursuit. If I stay in and he EQs... He'll outspeed me and kill me. He's definitely... He's gotta be scarfed. He's got to be scarfed. He's going for a rock or a ground move. If he's banded, I'll learn that pretty quickly. Let's go Nodonado. I'll be okay to maybe get a wish to decisions a little bit later. Let's go Nodonado here. I'm going Nodonado. I think he'll go pursuit. No, he doesn't go pursuit. Okay, what's he locking himself into here? Stone Edge, maybe? Stealth Rock. He just wants the rocks up. Okay. I still think he's scarfed. I still do. What's a good switch for him here? Togekiss. Togekiss is okay. Chestnut, maybe. Chestnut can take both of the moves I'm packing with aplomb. I don't think he's staying in. I'm going to switch into... I'm going to switch into the red one. Just because I'm still convinced, with the spread he's got, I'm convinced he's scarfed still. Because he doesn't have any HP or attack investment, given how hard I hit him with that Sacred Fire. So, there's no point in him staying in and repeating rocks. He is going to withdraw. He withdraws first. He would have anyway. And he's going to go back into El Guapo. So, good. So, I got him there. Now... The issue here is that he's probably going to go back into T-Tar. To try and get that pursuit off. So the question becomes... Latias. That pursuit will not two-hit KO me if I stay in. Crunch will one-hit KO me. So if he locks himself into Crunch, I am definitely in trouble. He's going to go back into T-Tar now. So I could go back into Zoolander. I'd like these hazards gone. I really can't do much to the T-Tar as Latias. Several of my Mon can, but he's going to play really defensively around that, and he's going to keep switching and not let me take advantage of this. So if he's going to switch... Well, you know what? Let's, he's switching into T-Tar, and he's scarfed. We go back into Nado Nado, but what's the point? No, let's stay in here. Let's stay in here and go for Ice Beam. I think he's gonna switch. No, he stays in and lets me Ice Beam him. Oh, please take him out. Ah, it doesn't quite. It does a good amount, though. He sees Life Orb. He's gonna Leech Seed. See, now there's a good chance he goes into T-Tar. Because he won't survive another Ice Beam, and he's not going to be risky with this gentleman here. I'll have a chance to recover later. Latias outspeeds a lot of his team. I will have that opportunity. I think T-Tar comes in here. He's got a lot of hazards up, though. He really does. I'd like to recover, and I'd like to get rid of the hazards, to be honest. I think I can recover now, because I'm just going to be giving him more. I got to get out of here. I've got to get out of here, and I've got to pressure. Can Cuddles? No, Cuddles is going to get outsped by T-Tar. I should have switched him in last if I thought he was coming in. Scarf T-Tar is a problem. Definitely is a problem. I could go Omar here and switch a Roo, but then I know I already know he's Scarf, so why would I even do that? Let's do it anyway, just in case he stays in, does some shenanigans, spikes again, or something. I can always Volt Switch. I think he's switching into T-Tar here. Nah, yeah, so there's the T-Tar. Sandstorm subsided. That's good. So he's gonna lose his special defense here. I can Volt Switch here. Tyranitar not in the sand and Manectric. Yeah, let's Volt Switch. Will do a nice 23. We'll chip this guy down a little bit, and we'll see what he goes for. Wow, that's a crit. Oh my goodness, that's a crit. Now, I don't have a Dark Resist. I don't have an EQ Resist. Obviously, the red one... Oh, hold on. So here's the question. If he looks at my team and goes, he doesn't have a Dark Resist, I'm safe to go for Dark type, then Hippowdon is the switch. If he thinks... Maybe this Manectric isn't Scarfed, and I can kill him with a Scarfed EQ. He goes for EQ. I could bring in Latias on the EQ that he's now locked into. He might not be. I mean, he could be Dragon Dance. He could have just bluffed this really well this whole time. He could be Dragon Dance. Entirely possible. But I think he's Scarfed. So if I switch in Latias, and he goes for EQ... No, this is too risky. I don't think he's going for EQ. I'm gonna switch into Nado Nado here. If he went for EQ right now, and I could have switched straight in crunch. Oh, thank God. Okay, if I'd gone into Latias there, that would have been bad. So there's the crunch. That's not doing too much. That's not doing too much at all. Calcing. Okay. So, El Guapo, his chestnut, is the switch into this Hippowdon for days. I could get up my own stealth rocks here. I could switch if I predict the El Guapo is coming in. However, I don't want things taking too much damage, and he might just stay in and go for the crunch. I'm gonna go for the EQ here. He is gonna withdraw into El Guapo, probably. Yeah. So, I could have switched there predicting the El Guapo, but it's still going to be a bunch of residual damage, and my switch in there is Latias, and while I could have done that, I could have switched Latias there. It's risky. It's really risky because he was locked into crunch. Which worth mentioning here, his Tyranitar. Tyranitar has crunch, stealth rock. He's gotta have pursuit. I refuse to believe he does not have pursuit. He's safe pretty much to go for another leech seed or another layer of spikes here. I need to Mega Evolve at some point. Cuddles could come in here. He could double into T-Tar. But T-Tar's weak and Cuddles could. Let's switch into. There's so much damage he's going to take from this. I really need the red one to come in and defog. Fizz loves the double though. Tell me what. Why don't I get some rocks up right now? I'm gonna go for Stealth Rock here. He's gonna go for Super Fang and miss it. Okay, Super Fang. Now I have my rocks up. Super Fang. Interesting. Interesting. I guess because he can't hit a good amount of my team very hard, so Super Fang is a decent hit on everything. I think he'll Leech Seed now. I think he'll Leech Seed now. So I could EQ just to work a tiny bit more damage onto him. If he goes for Super Fang, I can slack off the next turn. Because I'm not sure who his switch in is to me. If all he's going to do is just Super Fang me. Let's EQ. I know it's not doing much, but yeah, he is going to Leech Seed this turn. I can recover next turn. I know this is not doing much, but the thing is it's not safe for me to switch for no reason. That was a crit too. It's not safe for me to switch for no reason. Not for no reason, but it's not safe for me to switch if I predict that he'll predict me to leave and then go into T-Tar. So I could slack off here to get healthy again. We're about halfway through the battle timer here. I know it feels a little stally. I'm gonna go the red one. His rockers and stuff are getting pretty weak at this point. Yeah, okay. His rockers and spikers are getting weak enough that the red one can defog now, and if he goes down, he's gonna double leech seed, predicting the switch. That was a good play on his part. We know the Scarfed Crunch is coming. We know I'm getting whittled. We know the T-Tar is going to want to come in. Can I kill him? Can I outright kill that T-Tar? Calcane. Draco will straight up kill it. Draco will straight up kill that T-Tar if it switches in right now, I think. In the sand, though? Even in the sand. And will it kill this Chestnut? Yeah. Yeah, well, alright, I'm gonna click Draco. He's gonna sacrifice Al Guapo. Ah, shoot, because now the hazards are up to stay because T-Tar comes in and pursuit traps me. That's okay. Man, I should have defogged first. Shoot. T-Tar comes in and pursuit traps me. Yeah. T-Tar comes in and pursuit traps me. T-Tar is weak, though. And we're setting up for a situation in which Entei outspeeds the rest of his team, barring the Stoutland, and can just click Sacred Fire over and over. If T-Tar comes in, I click Defog to once and for all scout to see if he's scarfed. Because I'll outspeed him if he's not. He could be banded. He could have been bluffing the scarf the whole time. Chestnut's gone. Let's click off Chestnut. Where are you, Chestnut? All the way down here. Okay, Chestnut's gone. 6-5. He is going to send out Nuh. He's going to whip up the Sandstorm. He's going to take a little bit of damage. And he's gonna take out Latias here, probably. I gotta click the defog. And I think he clicks Scarfed Pursuit. And then he takes me out and ensures that the... Yeah, so he's Scarfed Crunch. So I could have switched, but I probably would have died to that regardless. But with Nuh at that level of HP, Omar can come in. Omar can come in and can Volt Switch and kill him or net me momentum. It's Volt Switch. Who's coming in to take it? If he protects the Starmie well, he might have this game. Because Starmie does naturally outspeed a majority of the remainder of my team. Vaporeon can take it on pretty well. I'm actually going to probably want Vaporeon to come in next. Would be an ideal situation. Hopefully Togekiss comes in. No, there's no way. He's probably going to sacrifice Nuh here. It is unfortunate to have let Latias go down. It is, but oh, he is going to try and save it. Too sweet for me, bro. the Dublade. Man, I was considering switcherooing there, and that would have been awesome. Man, that does so much. Oh my god. Oh my. That does so much damage. That's crazy. That is crazy town in the United States of America. Is that an offensive then? Could he be double dance against Manectric? I mean, he definitely doesn't have any, because that did more than 50, so he doesn't even have full HP investment. He probably has Eviolite. There's no way. Oh my god, I'm just happy. All right? Nothing wrong with that, guys. I can be happy. I could go into Cuddle. No, that's not good. Nodonado, I think. I'd like to be healthier because I'd like to be able to switch in on that. I'd really like to be able to switch in on the Stoutland a little bit more. But that said, I think I'm actually okay to not click Slack off here. I do have a switch into that Togekiss in Vaporeon. Vaporeon is he healthy enough? Full health, absolutely full health. All right. Rock Slide would hurt the Vaporeon. Wouldn't do jack to this too sweet for me. Slack Off is a safe middle ground play because it keeps Nodonado healthy, allowing multiple switch-ins to several other threats. Earthquake will probably not even kill this. It'll get close though. He can't do much to me outside of Toxic. I'm still gonna have the opportunity to try and kill him with an EQ after I slack off. Let's slack off here, predicting the switch. No, he's gonna magnet rise to avoid the EQ. That's cute. Very good. Very good. Meaning. My way of killing him is decisions. He can't really safely switch in right now. Zoolander is my answer to Togekiss, who can't do a whole lot to several of the rest of my team who can outspeed him unless he's scarfed and he's double scarfing. And several of my other moms can take him out pretty easily. So let's go Zoolander. I'm not defensive, so this Dewblade can definitely hurt me. It has 110 base attack. Gonna go for the Toxic. So we know Toxic and Magnet Rise on the Dewblade. I think I'm gonna go Wish, then Heal Bell. Yeah, Wish then Heal Bell. I think he'll switch. He could have SD. Maybe I should have scalded. But I'll get a Wish up one way or the other here. Is the only status on my team, which is why I'm not in a super big rush to get the heal bell off. Now might even be a nice circumstance. He is gonna withdraw. Okay, maybe Starmie. Yeah, Starmie, and we see that the burn is gone, so we know that it is not analytic, and we know that the best it has for me is Psyshock. Sandstorm subsides, which is nice. a little lefties, a little chip damage. The Psyshock won't kill me. He's probably going to go for recover to try and keep himself healthy. I'm just going to go for the heal bell here to get rid of this. There's no way he predicts me to switch here. He's going to go for the Psyshock. I don't really have anything that wants to take it. Just got to get rid of this Toxic. Toxic and Magnet Rise on Dewblade. He could Rapid Spin. No, he's going to go for the Psyshock. That's a crit. Oh, I can't believe that. I honestly cannot believe that. I mean, I got a crit earlier. Man. Spikes and Stealth Rock. No wish coming true for me. That is so unfortunate. I predict he sacrifices T-Tar here. Predict it. You know what? I'm going to click Thunderbolt. This guy's done. This guy's done his duty. I think he goes T-Tar to set up the sand for Stoutland. I'm going to click T-Bolt. Man, I can't believe that. That Psyshock crit was unfortunate. You can switch Dewblade here. It'll go down. Starmie stays in. It goes down. Nuss sacrifice to bring in the Stoutland. The T-Tar goes down. Omar will go down to the Stoutland. I get a safe switch into Hippowdon. Baits the Starmie to come back in, but only as a revenge killer, and it'll get killed by any of my priority attacks. I really need to start... Yeah, Nut comes in to set up the sand. Sacrifices itself to rocks. Oh, that means the sand doesn't get up. Oh my god, that means the sand doesn't get up. I am so happy right now. Oh my gosh. Sand doesn't get up if he switches in and dies to rocks. I'm not even mad that I don't get a kill for that. 19 minutes left on the clock. Oh, Vaporeon is dead. I need to click that one off. need to be better at this, guys. Okay. Oh, this is a good battle. So... Dewblade will go down, Starmie will go down. I don't know that Togekiss will definitely go down. But Togekiss isn't much of a threat. Manectric. Yeah, Togekiss, not if he's defensive. So, Colin, with no sand up. obviously I'm locked into Thunderbolt. And if I switch out and back in, I'll die to hazards. So, definitely best bet here is to just click that Thunderbolt again. Do as much damage as I can to this man. That's a lot, and he locks himself into a Banded Return. Without the sand up. Without the sand up. I definitely outspeed him with Entei. Entei can kill the Starmie, except if it switches in. Entei can do a lot here, but I probably only have one more switch into him. Cuddles can come in. And I will outspeed. And can go for the close combat. I'll outspeed everything except for the Starmie. for whom I will quick attack and kill. Cuddles could maybe finish the game here. Let me just verify that I'm jolly max speed. I am. Let's go. I mean, yeah. You know what? Yeah, let's go Cuddles here. And let's see. Mega Pinsir, just to be safe. Calking. Knockoff will do 42 to 50% to Colin, which should kill it if it chooses to stay in. I outspeed even before the Mega Evolution, so that's okay. If he predicts the return of the close combat, he might switch into his two swords. Well, I'm pretty sure I could follow up kill. I'm gonna click knock off here. I think he sacks Colin though. I honestly think he does. This should kill him one way or the other. I'm gonna click knock off here. He's gonna stay in. Oh man, if I goofed and this doesn't kill, I'm gonna be really upset with myself. Please kill, Cuddles. You are such a beast. Please kill. Oh my god. I live at 10. Oh man. Silk scarf. Not choice scarf. Cute. Very cute. Oh man. That was a dumb move on my part. No, it wasn't. Because if I went for return. Wow. Quick attack here in case he has a priority attack. The Dewblade will have Shadow Sneak and will likely come in here and go for it. Stoutland is gone. Togekiss is still here. Too sweet for me, bro. Yeah, he's got me because I have to go for... He's probably got his priority attack in Shadow Sneak. And so... Ugh, I did that wrong. Because I could have taken Shadow Sneaks for days. I should not have done that. Man. I really thought he was switching, though. So, there's a chance he doesn't have Shadow Sneak. And Quick Attack will do 8% to this man. It's not going to matter. I click Knock Off here. Because it's the most damage I can do to this Dewblade. And if he doesn't have Shadow Sneak, it's my best attack. I gotta do it. He does have Shadow Sneak. There's no point in me Quick Attacking for minuscule damage. I handled that a little badly. Not even necessarily badly. I honestly expected him to try and preserve the Stoutland. I should have thought a little harder about that and realized he wasn't going to do that. I have Nado and Decisions left. I forgot that Omar went down also. He magnet rises if I go into Nado. So I gotta do decisions and hope. Let's see what my health is coming in. 134. Do I have two switches? 134 down to 64? I don't think so. That did 70. That means he has the game because I can't switch out. I have to click Sacred Fire here to take out Too Sweet for me, bro. And that means Starmie comes in, outspeeds, and kills the last two mon. So I lost by clicking Knock Off instead of Return there. How do I win? How do I win here? I have to click Extreme Speed to kill that Starmie. But if he stays in, obviously I got nothing, and it's not going to affect him at all. Let's fight for differential here. Ugh, I'm so mad at myself. If I just clicked return. He's really going to switch into Boo? I'm not sure why. He'll still win because it doesn't matter who. That was a crit. So many crits this game. It doesn't really matter because he can still switch into Starmie and take this game. Because the whole point is that I don't survive another switch in. And he can click. He can click Surf twice. And click Surf twice and win. So it sucks. Man, so close to having enough HP to do this, but what chances do I have here? I have the chance that he's not, that he's EV'd to be kind of bulky and that I outspeed him, in which case I should just go for an attack here. I have the chance that Hippowdon lives a surf. There's no way, but that Hippowdon lives a surf as he goes for it, and he takes two ticks of that damage. I die in the inset, and that's a 1-0. The only way I have to win this is to Sacred Fire and hope he doesn't have the speed investment. He does have the speed investment. Surf will take me out. Ugh. Life Orb hit won't kill him, so I can't just recover stall him even if I can survive one. So let's do, if he's trying to preserve differential, he'll switch into just click Earthquake. Man, it was close. Good game, Fizz. I'm really mad at myself for overpredict. I literally, if I'd thought this through a little more, I would have had the game. I needed to click return to just to assume he was going to sacrifice that poke. I mean, I thought knockoff would kill it. I really honestly did think knockoff would kill it. If I'd knocked off, if instead of knocking off, I'd returned and he'd switched, I could have gone for the knockoff next turn, and I threw it away. I threw it away right there by clicking the wrong move with Pinsir. I am really upset with myself. I even could have gone into Entei. There's so many things I could have done different there. I lost the game with a knockoff. Okay, well, you guys should check out Fizz. He's a great dude. He took this game fair and square. Very good setup. I thought I played okay. A couple of stupid errors on my part, but definitely go check out Fizz. He's got a great personality for these kind of things. Takes the 2-0 victory here, and not much else to say. I'll leave all those links and stuff in the annotations down below. As always, my name is Jim Leader Geo. You guys are the challengers. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys next time.